I told you that you should number the production rules. Here I am not numbering, but you should number it. And once you number them, you should keep the numbering fixed until the generation of the parsing table. So just imagine, parsing means what? To generate a parsing tree. So I don't know whether those people who are using mobile phones, they might not view this slide clearly, but those people who are using laptop or a desktop, they might view clearly the generation of the parsing tree. Means this is nothing but it is a sequence of application of the leftmost derivation rules to derive a given statement id plus id star id. So we have generated a parse tree like this, and we here start symbol here is e. So we start with t e dash, then we explore t by a t dash like. So you go through this, you download this PPT and just coolly see slide number whatever the slide is there. You read this slide after the end of the session, and you will learn how the parse tree is generated, we can understand how this parse tree is generated by actual derivations. So what I am doing is that I am giving you this as a homework, and I suggest you deliberately do manually with pen and paper on copy by using these production rules. Try to derive this given statement. So some people may say that ki isme kya hai bhai, ye bar bar aisa kyun kehte hain, but it is very important, because when you work out, then you understand certain things which are not captured in some lecture. That is a thing which is something you have to experience it. So by using the leftmost derivations, and we can match the generation of the parse tree. I have told you in previous slides. So just this I am giving you, that in this way we can generate. See here, I am not writing the rule numbers, but from this slide you can understand we have generated successfully the given string. It means that in this given string of tokens, actually this is a string of tokens. So this string of tokens is syntactically correct. This string of tokens is grammatically correct, right? So, and how this proved? By application of leftmost derivations. So you can visualize the generation of the parse tree in terms of steps. So whatever you have seen in a previous slide, this one, it is actually, this tree is generated corresponding to the steps of this derivation. Please note this. And I will switch to another point. Let us say, anyway, in top down parsing, as I told you, that there is a something called as a recursive descent parser and a predictive parser. Now I will not talk much, but you have seen this slide, but you think on this slide. What I want to say is that if a parser is with backtracking, I will be telling you what is a backtracking soon after this slide. So if you are using a backtracking, then it takes too much time. Normally we say it is exponential time. Those people who learn what is the order of complexity of some algorithm, they know what is a linear time, what is exponential time. So backtracking parsers are normally avoided because they work with exponential time. So backtracking parsers, like example RDP, recursive descent parser, has some advantages. What is advantage? That implementation of backtracking parsers are very easy, but definitely on another side they have some disadvantages. And in case of predictive parser, what happens? If your grammar has some kind of recursion, we remove it by doing elimination and lift factoring, and we generate something called as a look ahead. So I will be just immediately telling you what is look ahead. But grammar without the recursion works linear time, means you can easily understand that predictive parsers are more faster than recursive descent parser. Now, what is the problem with predictive parsers? The problem with predictive parser is that you cannot implement complex structures of your programming language. Now, what is complex control structures? Complex control structures can be if then else, switch, while, do while, repeat until, or if you call some procedure or function, then nesting of the procedures. These are something called as a complex programming constructs, control constructs. So predictive parser has some inherent limitation in it. So if you want to design a powerful programming language, then your parser should be, you should not use a predictive parser, because predictive parser lacks something. So anyway, you think on this slide, I am going ahead. Hope you are listening me clearly. I suggest you please send me snapshots, screenshots on my personal WhatsApp so that I will understand everything is going okay. Now, let us talk theoretically what is a recursive descent parser. Now, RDP, it uses recursive procedures to scan the input. Second, it may use backtracking. It may use, please note this thing, it may use backtracking and may do repeated scan, may do repeated scanning. Scanning is what? You are substituting something. And backtracking parsers are rare and inefficient. Uses LMD. So recursive descent parser uses leftmost derivation. That is the summary. Now, there is a predictive parser. So predictive parser is a special case of recursive descent parser without backtracking. So this is one point. You should note this. And if alternative or multiple choices are there, I hope you are able to read this. If alternative or multiple choices are there, choices means right-hand side of any non-terminal, there can be multiple production rules. So the problem that which production rule or alternative we should choose, that could be a problem. And that is solved in predictive parsing. How? That every alternative of some non-terminal on the right-hand side starts with different symbol. So you can choose easily the alternative. Now, something in little detail, what is a recursive descent parser? So recursive descent parser, directly production rules in a given grammar are coded. Means what is the production, production rule is there that is directly simulated. You write a code for a non-terminal, right-hand side of a non-terminal, right? I will be showing you what is how it is coded. And it uses manually recursive procedures based on the left hand side of a grammar, LHS of a grammar. Actually, it takes exponential time. This is wrong. You correct in your slide. Now, in recursive descent parser, we don't need parsing table. We need parsing table in different parsers. It's a top-down method, starts with start symbol, finds the leftmost derivation for input string. It may involve backtracking. I try to simplify it. There might be some points repeated, but intelligently you remove certain things and keep the relevant things. I have just made it for, perhaps I am oversimplified it, but this is how we can explain what is a RDP, recursive descent parser. You can get theory in books. Now, Let us understand what is the meaning of the backtracking. Let us say on the left side, there is a grammar. S and A, these are the non-terminals. S has only one production rule and A has two production rules, AB and small a. Now, in red color, there is a string of tokens, CAD. Now, suppose you want to derive it. You want to check whether grammatically this is correct or not. So, what you will do? You will do the derivation, either leftmost derivation or rightmost derivation. Or you can generate directly a parse tree or a syntax tree for that given string. So just imagine that we have applied the rule number one, CAD. We can generate a tree like this. Then we can explore capital letter A, that is non-terminal, CAD. So we have generated a part of the parse tree. But we know that the tree must terminate successfully. It should terminate successfully with the given statement. So what is happening? The second tree is not matching with the given statement. So what we are doing, we are applying another production rule, because A is giving you lowercase ab or A is giving you small a only. So I don't know, but just try to match it with understand what is the meaning of the backtracking. Sometimes it may happen that we may choose the wrong production rule to derive the string. So we may go on generating the tree and our output do not match the given string of tokens. So we have to backtrack. So on right side, we can generate the string. So perhaps this example may have given you idea what is the meaning of the backtracking. We have to back if we choose the wrong production rule. So we choose the green right and which matches. So if you traverse this tree in pre-order way, it will match your given string of statement. So anyway, now just imagine, what is a recursive design parser? I said that you just write a code for a production rules of a given grammar. Every grammar has some language. Every language has some grammar. So let us say this is small grammar representing some language. In blue color, it is given there. And in the box, just imagine that we are writing a code to simulate start symbol S. So procedure S is there, we begin. If input symbol is C, lowercase c, then begin. Advance means we advance the pointer. It means let us say that given string of tokens is stored in some buffer or some input tape. And we start reading from left to right and we advance the pointer. So we advance, then if input symbol is equal to D, then we advance light. So somehow, this procedure or this code, actually this is a mnemonic, pseudocode. So it is matching with the given production rule, yes. And similarly, we can write a code for non-terminal A. So let us say this is a sample code given matching with the production rule A. So later you download this code, this slide and go through it. So it doesn't mean you can write some pseudocode for any grammar. So if we code some grammar production rules like this, so that will act as a recursive descent parser for your language or compiler. So this could be one example. Do not get panic. You just go through these slides. You will understand. Now here, let's say this is same grammar, but for example, expression is giving term plus sign term, term is giving you factor, multiplication sign, that is a star factor. Factor is giving you in bracket expression or ID or number. So expression, term, and factor, let us say these are the non-terminals. So we can write a code for it. So let us say there is a procedure, match, which is mapping the non-terminal expression. So try to understand what is the EB and F, extended Buckus-Knorr form. Google it. What is that? So EB and F is nothing but it is a way of representing some grammar in a when we use some tools like Lex or React. So whatever grammar we write in terms of EB and F, that you will learn what is EB and F, Buckus-Knorr form, extended Buckus-Knorr form, while learning the SQL, maybe in a DBMS in a final year. So just imagine that this expression non-terminal is matching with this code. This is pseudocode. Now, in same way, there is a term non-terminal. There is some code for it. And there is a factor non-terminal. There is a code for it. You go through it and you will try to understand. And just imagine that you are writing a code directly for a given grammar. And that's why it is called as a recursive descent parser. So whatever that code, combination of code or clubbing of the code will act as a parser. Now, you know what is Java parser? Java parser is to generate the parsing tree. That's it. So anyway, I will not waste time because this is a theoretical concept. Just let's move to the next slide. Now, just try to understand what is a predictive parser. There are some points. There might be some repetition of the points, but for simplicity, just go through it. It may clear the idea. So actually, top-down parser means LL parser. Normally, in top-down parser, we use LL grammar. And in bottom-up parser, we use LR grammar or LLR grammar or SLR grammar. So right now, we shall try to understand what is a LL1 grammar. I will be giving you definition in next session. So let's see what is a predictive parser theoretically. Predictive parser has a capability to predict which production rule is to be used to replace the input string, given string. The predictive parser does not suffer from backtracking. We remove the left recursion and we do the left factoring, right? Then the predictive parser uses the look ahead pointer, look ahead symbol, which points to the next input symbol. So we shall try to understand what is a look ahead symbol. To make the parser backtracking free means non-backtracking, the predictive parser puts some constraints on the given grammar. Means that is called the transformation, left room elimination of the left recursion as well as left factoring. That is a constraint. It accepts the grammar that is known as a LLK grammar, or it may be LL1 grammar, LL2 grammar. We shall see what is the meaning of the K1234. And hence the predictive parser is also known as LL1 parser. This is a simplified description of the predictive parser. Now, as I told you, we can call predictive parser as a LL1 parser, LL2 parser, LL3 parser. The LL1 means what? It means there is a one look ahead. LL2 means what? Two look ahead. Three means three look ahead. In this way, K look aheads can be there. So look ahead means it is nothing but look ahead means a terminal symbol. Terminal, lowercase letter. We know capital letter is a non-terminal. Terminal is a lowercase letter. So letter or symbol. So for example, ID is a symbol. Opening bracket is a symbol. Closing bracket is a symbol. Plus sign, multiplication sign, minus sign is a symbol. So we can call symbol. So if there is a one symbol in the beginning of the right-hand side of a production rule, then we call it as a LL1 parser. So LL1 parser accepts LL1 grammar. LL1 grammar is a subset of a context-free grammar. We have seen previously the Venn diagram, just recall it, but with some restrictions to get simplified version. In LL1 parser, first EL is a parsing the input string from left to right, and second EL means doing the leftmost derivation. And one means one input symbol or one terminal or one symbol like ID or opening bracket or star. Therefore, LLK means K-lookahead symbols. This is theoretical description. Now, how to build a predictive parser? So this is a simple steps. And basically, it is very simple, but we have to understand the algorithmic way, logical way of constructing a predictive parser. Actually, to construct a predictive parser means you are constructing something called as a predictive parsing table. So what we have to do? First step is to remove the unreachable productions. Means unreachable production means normally we avoid the unit productions. Just like in FSM, there are some states which are unreachable. In the same way, in given grammar, there can be some non-terminals which are unreachable. You cannot generate that non-terminal during your derivation. Then second step is to remove the ambiguity from the grammar. Then remove the left recursion. Then do the left factoring. Then compute first and follow sets of the grammar. First and follow set means what? We are generating some sets. For example, there is a non-terminal. So let us say there is a non-terminal yes. Then we can generate a first set for yes. We can generate follow set for yes or E. The follow set contains or first set contains only terminals. Some terminals are there. So sometimes first set can be empty or follow set can be empty. Or it may contain epsilon in it. And once we generate the first and follow set, then there is a table construction algorithm that I will try to show you. And by using that algorithm, we generate the parsing table. And after that, we shall learn how to use parsing table to parse a given string of tokens or statement. Now, there are two types of predictive parsers. Predictive parser, you got what is a recursive descent parser. So there is one category that is called as a predictive parser. So there is a predictive parser which has parsing table, and there is another predictive parser which don't have a parsing table. So a table, parsing table wala predictive parser rehta hai, aur bina parsing table wala predictive parser rehta hai. So we are going to focus on parsing table wala predictive parser. So if you don't want to build a parsing table, you can directly code the grammar. We have seen in RDP, we can write a code for production rules, right? So transition diagram can describe the predictive parser just like they can describe lexical analysis, but the diagram is slightly different. So there is one diagram for each non-terminal, and labels of H are terminals or non-terminals. So don't stuck on this. Just let us go ahead on slide number 25. So let us say this is a grammar. Now, what is look ahead in this grammar? See, the right-hand side of the production rules. So there is a E dash, there is a T dash, there is F. So what is happening on the right side? It starts with some terminal. So E dash starts with plus, T dash starts with star, and F starts with opening bracket. So this is called as a look ahead symbol. So if I ask you which LLK grammar is there, so this is the LL1 grammar, because right-hand side contains only one terminal. So right-hand side starts with one terminal, that is a plus, star, or opening bracket. So opening bracket is a terminal. That's why we call it as a LL1 grammar. So just see, the production rule is giving you TE dash. So this is a diagram on the right hand side. So state number 0, 1 and 2 is there. So what are you are doing? You are mapping this production rule into some diagram. So this is called as a transition diagram, right? So in this way, you can draw transition diagrams for all the non-terminals. So for example, for E dash, you can draw the transition diagram like this. So state number 3, it is a initial state. State number 4, you can switch from 4 to state number 5 on input, capital T. You can switch from state number 5 to 6 on capital E as an input. So AGS is input. So you switch from state one state to another depending on the input. Your input can be terminal or non-terminal, or sometimes it may be epsilon. So in this case, E dash, we have epsilon. So in same way, you can draw the transition diagrams for all the non-terminals. So for T, T dash is there. So we have generated state number 9. So all double circle states are final states. So as I told you, that you can generate such a fragments of transition diagrams, and then you can club them so that you will have a consolidated large transition diagram representing some grammar. So this is LL1 grammar. So if you write a code to implement these production rules, then it will be a kind of a parser, predictive parser. So it will be the parser without transition table. So just imagine these are the all transition diagrams representing all the non-terminals. And then you can add one state, extra state, that will be initial start state. So in here, what is happening? 0, 3, 7, 10, and 14 are basic start states of the non-terminals. But if you club all these, you can have one single start state, and there are some final states like 2, 6, 9, 13, and 17. So you can, you should not call this as a finite state machine. Actually, this is representing some grammar, and that is a LL1 grammar, or you can call it as a context-free grammar. So if you code this, so you will be able to generate a parser or you can call it as a predictive parser for your language or grammar. Now, how to construct a predictive parsing table? So this is different type of predictive parser. So predictive parser without the parsing table and predictive parser with parsing table. So this is algorithm. So right now, we should not try to understand, or we should not talk about how this algorithm works. But I will be definitely telling you how it works in a next session. But go through this algorithm. So it is given on page number 225 and section number 4.4. So that PDF is kept on the resources. As I told you that you should visit FTP site. Today I will share with you my YouTube channel link on your WhatsApp group. So you can revise some video lectures. So I have selected a video lectures I am keeping on YouTube. So I don't know. See, on every slide, there is something, one URL is there, https://sites.google.com/site/cmmankar. I don't know how many of you has visited this site. So I suggest you visit this site. Lot many resources are there. Typically, may be useful in your preparation of your GATE. So there is a lot much the study material. You visit this site, you visit my YouTube channel, you visit FTP site. FTP site, I have given you IP. And I told you, you use the Firefox, you don't use the Chrome, right? You use Chrome only for Office, means MS Office or a team. But I suggest you use Mozilla for FTP as well as YouTube or the site. Because Mozilla gives you the facility to open a PDF document on the browser itself. You don't need to download some PDF on your local desktop and then open that. Mozilla has that ability. Even Chrome has that ability, but many times Chrome, that feature don't work. So you go through this algorithm. I will be telling you what is happening in this algorithm. So I will not take much time, but see, this is a algorithm or a method. Actually, this is a theoretical concept. Don't get panic. It is very simple. As I told you that you don't need to use your brain. You have to use your common sense and you have to follow the rules, just like a pattern matching. I told you last time that you have to just do mechanically the things. So here a given grammar is there. And input is given grammar, that is a left factor and without left recursion. You get the parsing table. I will show you what is parsing table. Please keep with me for 2 or 3 minutes because I just want to tell you how a parsing table looks like, particularly predictive parsing table. Then what you have to do for every production rule, like A giving alpha, you have to do like this. This is what you have to do. For every non-terminal, you have to generate first set and follow set. See, we shall see how to generate a first and follow set for a given non-terminal in a given grammar. But so step number one is there. And then you have to match the parsing table. You have to fill the parsing table. So there is a dollar entry is there. So depending on the production rule, whether A to alpha, you have to add the entries into the rows and columns of that parsing table. And if there can be some cells in that table, which can be blank. So those blank cells are called as a error situations. So please recall, I told you how the errors are detected, how errors are detected. That was a homework. I don't know whether how many of you have tried to search the answer for that. So that was a homework. So error means what? If a parsing table contains a blank entry, then that is an error situation. So that is a syntax error situation. Now syntax error, you can just imagine it can be wrong parenthesis, matching parenthesis, or missing comma or semicolon, or some spelling like printf, to make a printf, make a P capital A, says in C language. So that thing is there. So you have to correlate that knowledge with this, what is error. So anyway, so this algorithm is there. So in next session, you just read this algorithm and attend my session. You will understand what I want to say. Now, so see, this was a grammar. We are working this grammar. E dash, T, T dash, whatever. So here, what is there? So there are five non-terminals, E, E dash, T, T dash, and F, and terminals plus star, opening bracket, closing bracket, and ID. Let us say for this example. And here, there is some parsing table is given. So on first column is there, that is a non-terminal, E, E dash, T, and T dash, and F. And whatever we compute, first and follow, by using that first and follow set, we are mapping, we are filling the entries of the parsing table. For example, on ID, we are putting production rule, T, E dash, on plus, and E dash, we are putting the production rule, E dash, giving T plus T, E dash. So just correlate it. It is given in figure number 4.17 in a book. But and this is ready-made table. You don't know how this table is generated. So in next session, we shall try to understand how to generate this table. So I suggest you try to understand that how we are mapping. We are mapping the lowercase capital letters, non-terminals on one side and terminals on another side. See here, ID plus star, opening bracket, closing bracket, and dollar is there. So dollar is a special stack symbol which indicates start of the parsing and end of the parsing. So we shall see theoretically, but just go through this slide. I'm going to show you one more slide. So perhaps it may be taking some time, but I will just quickly go through it. So predictive parser contains four things. One is input buffer, stack is there, parsing table is there, and output stream is there. That is output. So input buffer contains your given statement like that, like ID plus ID star ID. And it contains dollar at the end of the given statement. And some pointer is there, forward pointer or whatever. And stack is there. In stack, we do the push and pop operations. So, you know, the grammar has production rules. So depending on the algorithm, we may push entries into the stack or we may pop entries from the stack. So there is a term that is a BOS, bottom up stack. Bottom up stack contains dollar. Anyway, then parsing table is there. Parsing table is M. Actually, it is array, capital A and lowercase a. So capital A is mapping non-terminal. Lowercase a is mapping terminal. So just if you see slide number 30, this. So non-terminals are there. Capital lowercase letters terminals are there. So this is matrix, right? This is a matrix. So parsing table contains array like this. And output stream is there. Output stream is nothing but derivation sequence. We have seen derivation sequence, LMD derivation sequence in slide. So just one more minute, 1 minute. So this is how the parser is there. See, here input string is there or a buffer is there. In buffer, that given statement is there. And at the end of the statement, there is a dollar, just like buffer. So it is a marker, or it is a just like in book, you keep the marker. In the same way, this is a marker which tells that when you start parsing from particular symbol, you go on moving the pointer. And when you reach to the dollar symbol, it means that you have done the parsing. And during that, when you move your pointer one place ahead, sometimes you move the pointer, sometimes you don't move the pointer. So depending on the parsing table, you know, parsing table we have seen, depending on the parsing table, you do the actions. So what you do the actions? You may put something, push, or you may pop from the stack. So that is there. And at the bottom of stack, there is a dollar symbol. At the end of the buffer, there is a dollar. So in this way, we match dollar with dollar. And we refer the parsing table. So perhaps aaj ka jara dose bada ho gaya, but anyway, I will repeat this in next. But this is how predictive parser looks like. We have seen the predictive parsing table. So what we have to learn, we have to just understand how to build a predictive parsing table and how parsing actions are done. So that we are going to see in next session. So this is the algorithm, how the predictive parser means actions. This is the action algorithm, how actions are done. So you go through this slide, and in next session, we shall see these three algorithms, along with the two more algorithms, that first and follow set, how to compute first and follow set. And then we shall understand clearly. I want that every student should clearly understand, crystal clear understand how to generate a parsing table, how to generate a first and follow set, and how to parse a given statement. So this is a snapshot that how parsing is done. So if you refer the action algorithm, you will understand how it is parsed. So At the end, there is a dollar. Last row contains dollar. It means we have done successful parsing. The given statement ID plus ID star ID. So that I will be telling you later. So I hope you will do the homework. You will visit my YouTube channel as well as FTP site, as well as the MS Office resources. You download my video lectures. If you have any doubt, you send me on a personal WhatsApp. And I hope many people have done the registration successfully. If they have paid, but they are facing some problems, you will please send me the your difficulties or issues. I will try to solve. Thank you very much for listening to me. Thank you very much. So I'm going to end this meeting.